Let us see how to create an event within a calendar. To create a calendar, you need to click on Create button. This will bring you to the next page where you have a facility to name your calendar and set the share settings. The first thing you need to do is name your calendar. Here, I have set my calendar name is Meeting. You will have to set the date and time for the meeting. If you want to happen this meeting all day, then click on All Day option. There is one more option you can see, that is Repeat. This option gives you different facilities to set your meeting daily, every weekday, that is from Monday to Friday, thrice in a week, that is every Monday, Wednesday and Friday, every Tuesday and Thursday, weekly, monthly and yearly. For example here, if you select weekly, you will have to specify the day on which you want meeting to be happen. The next option is Calendar. This option specifies under which calendar this event is going to be placed on. Also, put the description in description box. You can upload a file, photo or any other documents using Add Attachment option. You can also change the color of your event by selecting color from color palette. This will help you to find one calendar within multiple calendars. Very important option you will get in Google Calendar is notification. We can add notifications here in Google Calendar. So, there are few different options. We can either have a pop-up notification or an email notification. A pop-up notification you are going to get only if you are in Google. Something like Gmail, Google Drive, Google Calendar or if you have set up on your mobile phone. However, if you are not logged in into Google, you will not going to get any notification. Next option is email notification. It means you are going to get an email notification before some minutes of the meeting. For that, you need to set the minutes. If you select the hours option, then specify the hours. Likewise, if you select the days option, then you need to specify how many days before the meeting day the notification should be emailed. Then there is one more option, that is weeks. You can also add second notification. You can add as many as notification as you like. Down option is to show me as available or busy. It means other people can see you as available or busy. The next option is visibility. It means who all can see your calendar. You can set your calendar as a calendar default. It means someone else can see the details for your events but will not be able to join. Choosing public will not make your event visible to the general public. But anyone you have shared your calendar with will be able to see the name and other details of your event. Private option means only people who you have given access to make changes to your calendar will be able to see the name and other details for your event. Now, the last section of this event is to add guests. Now, we need to go ahead and invite people to join us for a meeting and start adding guests to your event. You need to add email IDs of people to who all you want to invite. These people will get a notification via mail in their Gmail account, or it will going to appear on their Google calendar. You can also remove them from list by clicking on cross button. So this is how we can create an event. Now, click on the Save button which is on the top. It will ask you, would you like to send invitation to guests? Click on Send to send an invitation. Now, here you can see your meeting has been scheduled.